Hello friends, this is Gökçe from CGCave.com, and today I'm going to show you an alternative way to the pivot point. It's called the working pivot, and it's actually, again, we will use the pivot point. Everything is the same. The only difference is this doesn't change the pivot point of the object. It only creates a temporary pivot point that we can rotate things around or scale things. Let's try this with the same example. I'm going to create a box, nearly the same example. Let's change the dimensions to 40 by 40 by 20. And let's hit W to move this object to the origin. And then I'm going to create a teapot in here. And let's just move this to the zero in the y-axis. Okay. Now, what I want to do is I want to go to the hierarchy again. I don't want to mess with the pivot point. So I'm going to just close this box and I'm going to work with the working pivot. If I click on the edit working pivot, you will see that we have a temporary new pivot point. I can just change the position of this, move it anywhere I want. There are some helpful tools in here as well. I'm going to show them in a minute. But let's say we place this to the origin and let's hit OK. And now you can see that the use working pivot is active. Although the pivot point of the object seems like it changed, if I disable this, you will see that the original pivot point still is there. If I click on this again, it will use the temporary working pivot we just created. So if I hit E now and rotate this around this box, you can see that we have that option still. But the object's pivot point or the original pivot point is still there. Okay. So what are these helpful extra tools? Align to view is aligns the gizmo to the view. As you can see, if I just want to rotate this around the camera normal, you can see that I can do that as well. Let's hit W to see this a little bit better. You know, you can see that the Z axis shows the camera position. If I click on this again, align to view, you will see that Z axis shows where I stand in the 3D space. Okay. After I click on the align to view, if I just click on edit work pivot again, you will see that it was resetted and I can just hit OK again to start with a new working pivot. Okay. Also, here's the reset button. If I try these out, if I just click on the view and click anywhere on the scene, it will put the pivot point on that point, the clicked point, on the grid, I guess, yeah. If you have some kind of a different grid, it will put the pivot on that grid. If I decheck this align to view option and click again, let's reset this again and try that again. If I click view and click, and you can see that it won't align the Z axis. The Z axis won't look at the camera, let's say. Okay, that's a better explanation, I guess. So align to view is does the same thing with this button in here. And if I click on the surface button, I can just place this on any surface. Okay, you can see that I can just click here and start working from there. Let's do this for the box, for example. It may be a little bit more useful. As you can see, the use working pivot is active, so it still is using that working pivot. Let's click on edit again. And if I just click on the surface and put this in this corner in here, let's hit S and see that we can use the snaps as well. I can just place the working pivot in here real quick, and then I can just scale this from that point or rotate the box from that point. And you can see that instantly we have this fast, cool pivot option we can use. And we don't mess with the original pivot point. That's very cool and useful. I hope you found it useful as well. If you found this lesson useful, please hit the like button and the subscribe button and the notification bell next to the subscribe button. Thanks for listening. See you in the next lesson.